Welcome back. I am Rebecca Dias from Catch 25 Science Academy. Today's video is on hydrocarbons, which is a chemistry topic of grade 11. So let's begin. By saying this topic, what do you think? What do we mean by this word? Yes, hydrocarbon means the molecules that consist of hydrogen and carbon or carbons. Now you must be wondering, why did I mention only a single carbon? Because we know that methane is CH4 and methane has only one carbon. That's why I mentioned as only carbon. Moving into the chapter more deeply, let's clear our basic concepts first. Now, we need to really thorough it well, that what is the meaning of the basic concepts. Now, first basic concept which we have is a straight chain. Now, I've given an example to explain the meaning of a straight chain. Example, CH3-CH2-CH2-CH2-CH3. Now here you can see that I have 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it becomes pentane as it has 5 carbons. Now you can see that there are only 2 terminal points. That is this and then straight this. So we have only 2 terminal points in a straight carbon chain always. And now can you see that we have missed any carbons to count? No, we have counted all the carbons. So hence we have to not reverse back to go to any carbon. Means it is going straightly or easily. By my example I have displayed here, that is of CH3-CH2-CH2-CH3. Now here there are 4 carbons. So it will be butane as it has 4 carbons. Now here there are how many terminal points? 1 and 2. Terminal points means the starting and the ending point. Here, did we have to go anywhere to collect the carbon? No. Hence, it is a straight chain. Now we will go through another basic concept of branched chain. The word branched tells you the meaning. Branched chain means a carbon compound which will have a branch. Example, CH3-CH-CH3-CH2-CH2-CH3. First, count the carbon atom, carbons, to get the name of the alkane. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's an hexane as it has 6 carbons. We'll go to another example. CH3-CH-CH3-CH3. Now count again the carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 4 carbons. So it will be what? Butane. Right answer. Now from these two examples we notice some things. Now in the straight chain we have only 2 terminal points, but in a branched chain we have more than 2 terminal points, that is more than 2 end points. Like here we have this as our terminal point, this as our terminal point, and this as a terminal point. Start. The carbon chain can start from any end to come to get the alkane. And we have to reverse or return back to count the carbon atoms. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we have got 5 carbons, and but that was in a straight line. But here one is missing. So we have to come back again to count this carbon. So that's why we have to reverse or return back. Same in this case. We have again more than two terminal points. 1, 2, and 3 in a branched chain. Then we have to again reverse or return back to get all the carbons. Like 1, 2, 3. This, I have got only 3 carbons, but 1 carbon is here above. So I have to again come back to get this carbon. I hope you have understood this concept. Now we will be moving further with saturated hydrocarbon. Now saturated hydrocarbon means the carbon compounds which are bonded with each other in only single bond. They don't have double or triple bond between them. And saturated hydrocarbon includes alkane. Just before, the previous examples which we solved were all of alkane. Now we will go to unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now we have unsaturated hydrocarbon basically means those carbon compounds which are bonded with each other in only double or triple bonds. There is no single bond allowed in unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now alkene, which is included in unsaturated hydrocarbon, has only double bond. It cannot have triple or single bond, only double. An alkyne, which is another group which is included in unsaturated hydrocarbon, has triple bond. It does not have double or single bond in it. I hope you have understood both the concepts very well. Now we will learn about ring or cyclic chain. Now I have written the meaning of this in simple words below. Carbons bonded together in the form of a ring or cycle. Now what do you mean by this? That I will explain you through an example. Example 1, CH2-CH2-CH2 and -CH2. Now here you can see that all the carbons are like trapped. They are closed. They are not open like the previous examples which I gave you. These are all closed and hence they are ring or cyclic chain. We can even take example of benzene, which is also a ring chain or a cyclic chain. It means that it is a closed chain, it's not an open chain. Now we will take the help of this chart to learn the classification. Hydrocarbons is divided into two, chain and ring. Now I have taught you the basic concepts before so that you could understand this classification well. Now this chain is also known as open chain or aliphatic chain or aliphatic. Now the chain is divided into two parts as straight chain and branched chain. The straight chain is divided into saturated and unsaturated, the branch also as saturated and unsaturated, and the ring or cyclic chain is also divided into saturated or unsaturated hydrocarbons. The chain, straight, branched or the ring carbon chain can have single bond, double bond or triple bond. This is the meaning of these. I hope you have understood this chart. Now we will study the nomenclature of alkanes. Now there are some certain steps to give common name to alkanes. Alkanes are what? Which have only single bonds. So let's go through the steps. Step 1. To identify the longest continuous carbon chain. Second point, step 2, identify if it is a straight chain or branched chain. Step 3, decide the prefix. N dash or ISO or NEO. Now for common naming, we need to add some prefixes for before the alkanes. Hence this point has been added. Step 4, count all the carbons. Step 5, the prefix will come first and then the alkane. Now this I will teach you with an example. In a straight chain, we use N hyphen as prefix before an alkane. In branched chain, we use iso before an alkane as prefix and neo as prefix before an alkane. Now there are some conditions to apply iso and neo in a carbon chain when it is branched. Now iso can be used only when there is a methyl branch. Means methyl branch is CH3. CH4 is methane. If one hydrogen is less, it becomes a methyl branch. An iso, the methyl branch will be present on the second or second last carbon of the carbon chain. Neo. Now, neo will be used only when there are two methyl branches present on second or second last carbon. These two points of each of these prefixes is very important to identify which prefix has to be used where and when. How to name an alkene with prefix? I'm talking about the common naming. Let's learn together. So I have two examples over here as CH3-CH2-CH2-CH3. First step according to our chart is to identify the longest continuous carbon chain. Now here you see there is no branch. There are only two terminal points. So this is our longest chain. The full chain is our longest continuous carbon chain. Second point, to identify whether it is a straight or a branched chain. This is a straight chain because there are only two terminal points. No reverse is needed as all the carbons are counted. Next, to choose the prefix for the alkane. For straight chain, we only have to use a small letter N with a hyphen and followed by the name of the alkane. So we'll write that down. My first step is done. Now we will count the carbon atoms, carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means what? Butane. Right answer. So we will write capital B. So small letter N hyphen capital letter of the alkane. So this is the answer of the first example. Now the second example is also similar to the first one. Now tell me the longest continuous carbon chain. You're right. CH3-CH2-CH2-CH2-CH2-CH2-CH3. There are only two terminal points, no branches, no reverse is needed because all the carbons have been counted. Next, choose your prefix. No. Tell me, it is a straight chain or branch? Yes, it's a straight chain. And for straight chain, we use which prefix? N dash, right? N dash. Now count all your carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 means what? Heptane. Right answer. So we will write capital H, heptane. Yes, With these two examples, I hope you have understood the common naming system of a straight chain. Thank you. Now we will go through some more examples. Let's see. CH3-CH-CH2-CH3. And above we have CH, we have CH3. First step, to identify the longest continuous carbon chain. Now tell me which is the longest continuous carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Almost it is the same. Longest continuous carbon chain means we must get maximum number of carbons in the carbon chain. So we have got, so I will take this one as the longest continuous carbon chain. Second step, branched or straight chain. Tell me. Now here we got the longest continuous carbon chain. But still one carbon is there. It is not counted in this box. Means it is a branched chain. It has more than two terminal points. See here. 1, 2, 3. More than two. Yes, it's a branch. Now in branched chain, I told you that we have to use two kinds of prefixes as iso and neo. Now iso. When is iso used? When there is only one methyl branch on the second carbon. Now methyl branch is what? CH3. So you can see here, apart from this box, I have a branch here which is actually methyl. So, and it is on the second carbon. See if I count 1, 2, 3, 4. So, it's on the second carbon. If I count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it is coming from this on the third carbon. So, it won't be an iso. Because iso has to be only on the second carbon and has to have only one methyl branch. So, the answer for this alkane will be what? Count all, yes. And also you have to count all the carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In common naming, always remember to count all the carbons irrespective of being a branch also. Means you have to include your branch also. So I will write as iso. How many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, pentane. I hope you understood this example. Now next one. CH3-CH2-CH2-CH3-4. And CH3. First step, identify the longest continuous carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going in one flow. Yes. So I will go with this box. You can go with another also carbon. Okay. Second step is to identify branched or carbon chain. What do you think by looking at this example? Yes, it's a branched chain. Because you see that there is a carbon still remaining here and there is more than two terminal points. 1, 2, 3. So for branched chain, I have told you we have to use two prefixes, iso and neo. So your which prefix would you apply? Yes, it would be, and it has to be a methyl branch. Yes, methyl branch. So I will write it as iso because single methyl branch. Count every carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 carbons is which alkane? Hexane. Right. I hope you understood these two also. Thank you. Now we will do another example. Let's try it. First step to identify the longest continuous carbon chain. Tell me which is the longest continuous carbon chain. Yes, right answer. This box is consisting of four carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, only three carbons. 1, 2, 3, again only three carbons. So here this box has four carbons. Second step, straight or branch chain? Yes, it's a branch chain. How you came to know? Why? Because there are more than two terminals and you have to go reverse because you have not counted two carbons. Hence it's a branch chain. In branch chain we have two prefixes, neo iso. So in iso, what I told you, one methyl branch on second carbon, and in neo, two methyl branches on the second carbon. So here I have my methyl branches. How many are there? 1, 2. So 2, which is a condition of neo. So it will be neo. Count all the possible carbons in the carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 means what? 6 means what? Hexane. Right. So it will be neohexane. I hope you understood this example as well. Come on, let's learn a new concept. How to draw structures for the given alkane? Now always remember, if you get an alkane starting with iso, you always need to draw CH3-CH and above it CH3 and a dash near it. This means it's an iso alkane. Similarly, I will give you more tricks for neo as well. Now I have an example here as neohexane. First rule, iso. Iso, you have to catch it. We know what is iso. So we will draw it. CH3-CH above CH3 and dash. This is my iso. Now hexane has 6 carbons. Now, in iso you see how many carbons? 3. 1, 2, 3. Now hexane has 6 and iso has taken 3. So minus 3, you get 3. So you have to put more 3 carbons to draw the structure. So I will draw it as I have 3 carbons here as per this, and now I will fill the hydrogens. 1, 2. How many are hydrogens? 2. So H2. 1, 2. How many? 2. So again 2 hydrogen. And this carbon has only one bond. So I will put H3. So this is your structure ready for isohexane. We will learn about neo. Now you can see that I have drawn a structure here for neo. Whenever any structure comes for neo, you need to add this to identify that it is a neo alkane. So it is CH3-C- above C we have CH3 and below C we have CH3. Always remember that a neo alkane will should have minimum 5 carbons. So I have given you an example here, neoheptane. Let's draw. First neo, catch neo first. Write it down. CH3-C- below CH3, above CH3. Neo work is done. Yes or no? Yes. Now heptane. Heptane is 7 carbons. Neo has taken how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons neo has taken. So heptane 7 minus neo's 4 carbons. 7 minus 4 is 3 carbons. So let's add more 3 carbons. First you need to add only C like this. 1, 2, 3. Then you can fill the hydrogens. 1, 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. So H2. And 4 minus 1 is 3. So H3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Heptane. 2 methyl branches on second carbon. So neoheptane. I hope you understood. Now we will learn how to draw a structure if the prefix is N hyphen. So let's learn. N hyphen comes, then you need to see which alkane has come, like butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane. Depending on that, you need to know the number of atoms in an alkane. For example, here I've asked N hyphen butane. Butane is how many carbons we know? 4 carbons. You need to know how many carbons does an alkene have, whichever will be the question asked. So just draw 4 carbons. 4 carbons. Now 4 minus 1. We know the tetravalency of carbon is 4. So 4, we have a 1 bond already. So 4 minus 1 gives me 3. So CH3, here 4 minus 2, H2, again H2, 4 minus 1, 3, so H3. So I hope you understood this example. It's the easiest example and concept. It's compulsory that every alkane will have a common name. But in IUPAC naming, every alkane definitely has a name. Hope you have enjoyed today's video. I hope you have also understood all the concepts of hydrocarbons very well. Thank you so much.